Hey guys, in this video I wanted to go over how to create a word cloud in R. So I'm basically going to go over this short R code. And before I get into the R code, let me show you what the word cloud we're going to create looks like. So word cloud basically looks like this. So it looks like a cloud of words, and the words are different colors and different sizes based on the frequency that they appear in a data set that you're going to pass in. So for this particular video, I have different community areas in Chicago. This is an old data set that I have used in previous videos, so I'm just reusing it since I already have it. And it was from a gun violence video. So basically from this, you could interpret, for example, that the community of Austin in Chicago has more gun violence incidents compared to some of these communities because the community name Austin is bigger. So I'm going to go over how we can create a word cloud like this in R. So let's go ahead and get started. And I will put a link to the R code in the description box below. So the first line of code just sets my working directory. This is where I'm going to output the image file. So we're going to save the file as a PNG, and I'm just going to set the working directory folder for where I want the file to be placed at the end. Then I'm going to load in the following R libraries. So if you don't have these libraries installed yet, you first want to install these packages and then load in these libraries. So I'm going to load in the data table library to read in a data frame or a data set that I want to work with. I'm going to load in dplyr to do some manipulation on the data set that I'm loading in. I'm going to load in a library called grdevices, and this is going to help me save my image as a PNG. The actual R package for creating word clouds is called wordcloud. And then to get certain colors that I'm going to use in my word cloud, I'm going to also load in a package called Rcolorbrewer. So I'm just going to go ahead and load in all of these libraries with these lines of code. And then let's get into importing the data set. So in this line of code, I'm importing a CSV file that's going to have the data table that I want to use, whose values I want to use in the word cloud. So in this particular word cloud example, we're going to want to have two columns in our data table. So we want to have a column of words, and then the second column should be frequencies. That could be from whatever data set, but basically you want to have at least these two columns, and basically the sizes of the words in the word cloud are going to be determined by the frequency in our data table. So from this CSV, which has multiple variables in it, I'm just going to select two and basically do some cleanup of the data table. So I'm going to do that with the next couple line of codes. I'm basically going to get two columns. I'm going to rank the communities by gun violence incidences, and I'm going to select the top 70 communities out of 77 in Chicago, and basically put that in a variable called chi_table1. So if I look at this final data table, it's going to have two columns, like I said. It's going to have 70 rows, so these are 70 out of the 77 different communities in Chicago, and each row also has a column for incidents. So this is going to be the number of gun violence incidents in a certain period of time. So I think it was a couple of months. I think it was, I guess, 6 months. I don't remember though. But whatever the data set, it basically has a column of words and then a column of numbers, in this case, frequency. So you can see that when it's ranked, the number one community again is Austin. So we're going to expect that in the word cloud, Austin is going to be the biggest, and the size of the words should decrease as the number of incidents per community decreases. So we would expect words like Oakland or McKinley Park, which only have one incident, to be very small in our word cloud as well. So once we have our data table ready, we're going to set the output as a PNG file in this case, and we're going to actually use the wordcloud function from the wordcloud R package. So this line of code says to save the file, the image that we're going to create, as wordcloud.png. It's going to save it in the folder that I already set, and then I specify the height, the width that I want in inches, and a resolution of 300. So I'm just going to set that for the output that I'm going to create. And then this next line of code is what's going to actually produce the word cloud. So I'm going to pass in the two columns from the data table. So I'm going to pass in the column of the words, which is going to be in the community column. So the community has all the words that I want plotted. And then the frequency parameter, I'm going to pass in the number of incidents. So that's the second column. The other parameters in this function are basically optional parameters for how visually you want the word cloud to look. So if you look up ?word cloud, you can see information about what these optional parameters mean. The scale, for example, indicates the range of the sizes of the words. So I want them to be from 3.5 to 0.25 relative. The maximum number of words is going to be 70. And then the colors is going to determine the color palette that I want the different words to be. So in this particular case, I'm getting this from the R package, Rcolorbrewer. And then if I go to this website, which has some information about Rcolorbrewer Palette, and I will put a link in the description box below, you see that you have, using this R package, a couple different color schemes or color palettes that you can pick from. So when I ran this, I picked dark 2. So the word cloud, I'm going to have words with these colors from this color palette, but basically you can just pass in any of these names and then it will have the appropriate color palette using this R package. So you can see I put for colors parameter in word cloud brewer.pal, and then that took two values, dark 2, which is the color palette, and then dark 2 has 8 possible different colors for the words. So I just said to use 8, which is the maximum number of different colors. So then when I finally run this line of code, it's going to produce the word cloud in my working directory. So then if I go to my working directory, which is here, I'm going to find wordcloud.png in the folder, and if I click it, then I have my word cloud, which was created. So you see that according to the frequencies corresponding to your data table, you have different colors and different sizes for the different words arranged in a cloud. And that's it for this video, and thank you guys for watching.